Sharon Rivers represents that true parent that will do anything for their child. The love is just so deep. And Sharon and Joe Rivers, their children, they come out of an enormous amount of love. And you see that when you watch Tish and Fonny. You meet Sharon and Joe and you go, I think Sharon and Joe was a Tish and Fonny at one time.
What's the special occasion?
You the man of the house.
Stop worrying.
But of course, madame.
In the part of the film when Sharon goes to Puerto Rico, she's on her way because the woman that's wrongfully accused Fonny of rape has fled to Puerto Rico. And of the family, they have agreed that Sharon is the best person to go and try to convince this woman to come back. And especially when you look at the time period, it's not common for Black Americans to go to another country. Most Black Americans that are traveling to another country, it's usually Jamaica or one of the West Indies. It's the country that their parents are from or their grandparents are from, so they're going to actually visit family. But to go to another country as a Black American in the 50s, 60s, and not speak the language, not have any family there, have any friends there, just shows the lengths Sharon would go, this family would go for each other. We were having conversations of how Sharon was going to wear her hair in the film, like what hair represented Sharon. And I told him just how big wigs were then. They're still big now. They've just come a long way. They have evolved. And what did he feel about this wig is almost like, you know, your suit of armor, like your costume, you know? And we felt like in that moment, does the armor really feel like armor? Are you really feeling protected? What is it like when you're really all alone? I felt like there's a moment where, you know, she's getting ready and she goes to get the wig with the intention that, oh, I'm put on my armor. And it doesn't feel safe, it doesn't feel secure. And Barry felt that that was to be looking dead into the camera, which is the mirror, but right down the lens, and to show how vulnerable she was in that moment. After she's made the decision that I am gonna put on my armor and finds her way to the woman she's come to see, there's this moment I think that Sharon is trying to appeal to her, and every angle that she tries to connect with this woman, it doesn't happen. And I think it's really strong, the moment when they're speaking and she says,
one thing I can tell, lady, you ain't never been raped.
That's one thing Sharon never thought about. And that's the most terrifying moment. I think it's really right there when all I have left is faith and religion and daughter. And she goes to touch her heart. She goes to touch the cross.
Daughter, in the name of God, get off of me.
In that moment, I think Sharon's heart was like, wow, this woman was raped, and that's all she can hold on to. That's all this woman can hold on to. She's trying to live beyond it, but man, it's heavy.